Look here. I shall have a monopoly. They'll all belong to me, won't they? 2,000 policemen in the city of New York. Wages, $4 a day. I'll replace them with dead ones at half the money.
Oh, prodigious! I never thought of that. $4,000 a day. Now I do begin to see. But will dead policemen answer?
Haven't they, up to this time?
Well, if you put it that way.
Put it any way you want to. Modify it to suit yourself, and my lads shall still be superior. They won't eat. They won't drink. Don't need those things. They won't wink for cash at gambling dens and unlicensed rumholes. They won't spark the scullery maids, and moreover the bands of toughs that ambuscade them on lonely beats and cowardly shoot and knife them will only damage the uniforms and not live long enough to get more than a momentary satisfaction out of that.
Why, Colonel, if you can furnish policemen, then of course—
Certainly! I can furnish any line of goods that was wanted. Take the army, for instance. Now, 25,000 men. Expense, 22 millions a year. I will dig up the Romans. I will resurrect the Greeks. I will furnish the government, for 10 millions a year, 10,000 veterans drawn from the victorious legions of all the ages, soldiers that will chase Indians year in and year out on materialized horses, and cost never a cent for rations or repairs. The armies of Europe cost 2 billions a year now. I will replace them all for 1 billion. I will dig up the trained statesmen of all ages and all climes, and furnish this country with a Congress that knows enough to come in out of the rain, a thing that's never happened yet since the Declaration of Independence, and never will happen till these practically dead people are replaced with a genuine article. I will restock the thrones of Europe with the best brains and the best morals that